You're Catholic, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so I was reading this crazy article in the newspaper, and it was about like the Catholic Church in the modern world, and it mentioned something about the church having a rule about birth control being bad. Like, that's so insane. They don't actually think that, right?
Well, actually they do. The church has always thought that the use of contraception is morally wrong. And a lot of people, even a lot of Catholics, don't even know about it because nobody really likes to talk about it. Even priests, which is really unfortunate. Because it's one of our most important teachings and really relevant to the world we live in today.
Yeah, but you don't buy any of that, do you? I mean, it's ridiculous to expect people in the 21st century not to use birth control.
Actually, I do buy into it, as you said. The church's teaching about contraception actually makes a lot of sense and is really beautiful once you understand it.
Okay, hey, you keep calling it contraception. Isn't it birth control?
Actually, the real word for it is contraception. It comes from two Latin words. The first word is contra, which means against, and the second one is conceptio, which means conception. So the word literally means against conceiving, which is what contraception is used for. The words birth control only came around when people were trying to put a positive spin on a negative thing. Instead of contraception being seen as what it really is, a block to the creation of human life, they call it birth control to try to make it seem like it's only there to control the amount of human life that is created.
Okay, well, so you said that the church's teaching on contraception is actually reasonable once you understand it. Well, I'd love to understand more. Can I ask you a few questions, or is that awkward considering the subject? Okay, great. Alright, well, first of all, I guess just reading the basics, like, what's the bottom line of the church's problem with contraception?
Well, I guess the bottom line is that one of the church's most important missions is to protect the dignity of the human person, that is, the dignity that's inherent in every human life. The church teaches that a human life begins at the moment of conception, that is, when the sperm fertilizes an egg and an embryo is created. The church also teaches that sex is a holy and unitive act. It allows a husband and a wife to join together in a sacred act and be co-creators with God in the creation of a new human life. Contraception goes completely against the most fundamental and beautiful aspects of the act of sex. It deliberately prevents the creation of a sacred human life and creates a barrier between the husband and the wife and blocks the union with each other and with God that they should experience during the sexual act. Sex is also supposed to be an act of sacrifice and self-gift to the other person. When a couple uses contraception, it's like they're saying, here, I give myself to you, but not completely.
Okay, that makes sense. But the church can't deny that there have been lots of good advancements because of birth control, contraception. Women are more liberated in our society, and there are less unplanned pregnancies that happen now. It seems like contraception just made life a heck of a lot better for women.
Actually, if you look at the world around us, it has changed a lot in respect to the way we look at women, but mostly for the worse. Pope Paul VI wrote an encyclical in the 60s called Humanae Vitae, which means on human life, and in it he spoke of the negative consequences for our society that would come along with the widespread use of contraception. Some of the most interesting things that he said was that, first of all, there would be a greater amount of infidelity in marriage. Second, there would be a loss of respect for women. Third, that contraception would be used as a dangerous weapon by governments. And fourth, that it would lead to a false sense of freedom. If we look at the world now, 40 years after this document was written, it's almost amazing how clearly we can see these predictions taking place. In terms of infidelity and divorce, the divorce rate today is just over 50%. That's higher than it's ever been before. It's too easy to point out what a loss of respect has been for women in the last 40 years. I mean, just look at any magazine or advertisement or TV show. Women aren't looked upon as persons or human beings deserving respect. Instead, they're looked upon as people with a body that can be exploited to sell products or attract viewers. Also, along with increasing use of contraception, there has been an increase in cases of women being sexually assaulted or raped. When women aren't looked upon as persons anymore, men only see them as outlets for their sexual desires or aggression. Pope Paul VI's predictions about governments using contraception as weapons against their people really amazes me. Did you know that in China, the government only allows every family to have one child?
Oh yeah, I've heard that before. Yeah.
Well, they enforce that law by forcing women to take contraception, or contraceptives, or by forcing them to have abortions. There are also numerous cases of forced population control in other countries around the world that force women to take contraceptives or have abortions. Even the organization Planned Parenthood was created by a woman during the Great Depression who was trying to keep poor people from being able to have more children. That is essentially a form of eugenics.
Yeah, it's
a big word. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Eugenics is when, like, someone or something is trying to eliminate a particular race or class or kind of person.
Okay. condom and contraception is the only safe and healthy way to have sex.
No, yeah, I know. And like, healthy? No way.
Yeah.
One of the things that they never tell you in school about the pill is that it's terrible for a woman's body. It damages a woman's uterus and makes it difficult for her to conceive if she were to choose to have children in the future. Contraception actually has a lot to do with the high infertility rate of recent generations. Also, they don't tell you some really scary stuff about contraceptive pills. For example, some contraceptives allow the egg to be fertilized, thus creating an embryo, which is a human life, but make a woman's womb inhospitable for the embryo to grow, so it eventually dies. Those types of contraceptive pills are abortifacient, and they cause a woman's body to destroy the human life that has been created within it.
That's a really scary thought. How can anybody know any of this?
Like I said, people don't really want to talk about it.
But then it's like, what would the church want people to do instead of using contraception? I mean, like, have 15 babies?
Mm-hmm.
What is some, like, some people just don't have the means to have a huge family.
I'm so glad you asked about that. This part is really cool. There's something called natural family planning that the church is 100% okay with, and that is just as effective as any form of contraception, but it doesn't have any of the negative aspects that come with contraception.
Natural family planning?
Yeah, it was developed by two doctors in Australia. They studied women's bodies and found that there's only about 1 to 3 days during a woman's cycle that she can actually get pregnant. A woman's body shows certain signs when she's fertile or able to get pregnant, and when she's infertile. Natural family planning teaches couples to monitor a woman's body for these signs and use them to designate when they can have sex. For example, if a couple couldn't afford to have a child at a certain time, they could abstain from sex during the days of the month when the woman was fertile. Or if a couple wanted to have a child, they could make sure that they had intercourse on the day when she would be able to get pregnant. It's a really interesting and amazing thing that a woman's body does, but unfortunately nobody really knows much about it because contraceptives are such a dominant part of our society that people don't want to learn anything.
That's really interesting, but this is kind of an information overload.
Sorry,
no,
it's like
talking. That's okay, it's really cool to learn all that stuff. So same time next week?
Sure thing.
Maybe next week we can tackle quantum mechanics.